everybody. Thank you so much for coming this afternoon. We are so happy to have Ed the Wizard with us. And we do want to thank the Islam Meadow Cultural Council for sponsoring today's program. They are a part of the Massachusetts Cultural Council, and they are what allow us to have many of our programs here. So I'm going to turn it over to Ed the Wizard. Have fun.
All right. Can everybody hear me okay? Can you hear me back there okay? All right. Well, you must be able to hear me because you looked over your shoulder like I was pointing to somebody behind you. All right. Well, my name is Ed the Wizard. And let's see. Let's start off with a story. I'm going to try to stay away from that because I got to crank it up for it to work today. So for me, I grew up as Ed, the brother, the cousin, the friend, the dad, the uncle, like a lot of folks might, knowing a few magic tricks. How many here grew up knowing a magic trick or two? A card trick, maybe, or a coin trick? Or am I just an anomaly? One other. All right. Well, a lot of people, maybe not in East Long Meadow, but a lot of people tend to grow up knowing a magic trick or two. Everybody likes magic. And as your horizon gets bigger, as you get older, you have a lot more options facing you. And about 25 years ago, I read a story called Harry Potter, and I was inspired by the character Dumbledore. In the beginning of the movie anyways, chapter 4 in the book, Dumbledore goes to Fort Privet Drive, he takes a device called an outputter, and he sucks up all the street lights, making the drive dark. And right then and there, I was inspired. I wanted to be like Dumbledore. I wanted to make things disappear at my fingertips. So I took out the books I had on magic when I was young. I took out the books I gave my children on magic when they were young. I went to the public library and I taught myself how to make these disappear. But after you make something disappear comes the hard part. You have to make it come back. So I practice making things disappear, reappear, disappear. And you know what happens when you spend all that time practicing magic? You get hungry. So you get hungry. Now, do Pringles make a good snack? No. No, the answer is no. There's nothing good about Pringles that is good for you. But I like the container because if I'm hiking or camping or at the beach, the big size I can share, and then the container I can put all my trash recyclables in. And when I finish my water, which is a good snack, especially this summer, I can put it back in the box like that and take everything home in one trip. And then when I get home and I go to put my recyclables away, I take the water bottle out, and that's when I find I had forgotten all about my handkerchief that I made disappear, and I found it inside the recyclables. Give yourselves a great big hand. All right, so I understand some younger ones are going to come in, so I'm going to hold off on some of that until they get here, and which means I need some big volunteers. Let's see, I need a volunteer who knows their cards, and you can help me from right where you are sitting. Is there somebody that would like to help with an effect? Who here grew up playing cribbage with their grandfather? Nobody? I'm going to pick somebody. I'm going to pick this person right here, because we were talking earlier. Yeah, you, yeah. And what's your name, please?
Sonia.
Sonia, all right, Sonia. With a J or a Y?
I,
ooh.
It's really S-O-N-A, but I go by S-O-N-A.
All right. All right, well, Sonia, this, let me just set these aside here. This is about these four cards right here. It's not about me. It's about you and your imagination. Now, we got some little ones over here, and they may not, some in the back, they may not know what playing cards are. A lot of kids today don't know what playing cards are. So we're going to go with something they might recognize, maybe the face cards. Let's see, do you guys know what the kings look like in a deck of cards? Yeah? What do they have on their head? A crown. What do they have on their chin? What do they have on their chin? Beard. And what do they have in their hand? A sword or an axe or a scepter or a spear. So they know what the kings look like. Sonia, would you name me the four suits in a deck of cards, please?
Diamonds.
And clubs. Okay. All right. So if this doesn't work, it's not my fault. Can you name me the two black cards, the two black suits?
Let's see now. The club and the spade.
Okay. And the two red suits, two red kings.
The heart and the
diamond. All right, Sonia. So this is about you and your imagination, not the cards, not me. And so far, your batting average is around 500. I'm going to take two cards out of this packet. So, Sonia, using your imagination, did I take out the red kings or the black kings?
I'm going to say red.
Red. Sonia, you have an excellent imagination. You're now batting 750. I'm going to throw them away. They are gone. What two kings are left in that packet?
Black.
And what are their names?
King of Spades.
King. How about clubs?
King of Clubs and the...
King of Spades. King of Spades. King of Spades.
There you go, King of Spades. All right, I'm going to take out the King of Clubs and the King of Spades. As with the red cards, I want to throw one of these away. Which one do you want me to throw away, the King of Clubs or the King of Spades? Club. Which one of these is the King of Clubs? This one or that one? No, that's that one. This is this one. This is the King of Clubs? That one? Throw it away? One card left. This card. Your card, the King of Spades. Now, as I put the King of Spades back into the packet, imagine your card rolling over so that it's face up. Can you do that for me? We're back down to 500. Try. So you can see I have three cards face down. I have one card face up. Your card, the King of Spades. But it gets better. Back in the day, now you guys won't know this, but cards were either red or blue. Today you can get all kinds of cards, dragons and princesses and fairies and steampunk, all kinds of designs. But I want you to imagine your card, the King of Spades, with a red back. Can you do that for me? Because the only card in this packet with a red back is your card, the King of Spades, because we threw all the other cards away. Give Sonia a great big hand. Thank you, Sonia. All right. And let's start some music here. All right. Let's see. Business review. Let's see. I need a volunteer who has a bit of a portfolio and generally keeps up on business news. Anybody here have a portfolio, or are you all like me? You're laughing. So I know you got a business portfolio.
No.
Yeah. And what's your name, please?
Rebecca.
Rebecca? All right. You like to read, Rebecca?
My mom reads.
Your mom reads. All right. We'll give it to mom. Are you mom?
Yes.
Okay, mom. Oh, yeah, we got crossword puzzles there? No. All right, mom. You don't like to read. Okay, Mom, I want you to open up that book, that magazine. Open it up. And I want you to thumb through the pages. And you can stop anywhere you want.
Okay, I
All right. We can just go all the way around the room until we find somebody, but all right. And what's your name, please?
Brenda.
Brenda. All right, Brenda. What I want you to do is flip the pages. Make sure that the pages are free, because a lot of times a magician will glue pages together, forcing you to open up to the page they want. I am not a magician, I am a wizard. I have a different method of cheating. All right, so would you say those pages are all free? Or are you just gonna thumb through every single page?
No, they're okay.
Okay. What I want you to do is find an article and start to skim through the article. Doesn't matter which one, doesn't matter which page, I don't want to know. But what I do want you to do is you're going to search for a word within that article. Make it as big and hard and challenging a word as you can. Right, don't pick the word like the. Pick something really big and challenging. You got something? All right, keep the book open. Concentrate on that word. All right, so what I need for you to do now, Brenda, in order to help me find your brilliant thoughts against everybody else's, we're gonna look at a couple other words. Your word, the word immediately before it, would you look at that word? All right? Concentrate on that word that's immediately before your chosen word. That make sense? Concentrate on how many letters in that word. I'm getting two letters. Yes? All right. So with two letters, one would have to be a vowel. I'm going to go with O. Okay. O. And O is the first letter of that two-letter word. No, the second letter. Were you concentrated as hard as you were before? Okay. Concentrate on the first letter. I'm getting a G.
Yeah.
Okay. Now I do this, so that means the first letter would be, first word would be go. All right, I do this to help me connect our thoughts together. Concentrate, oh, that was a Sharpie. Oh well. Concentrate on that big word. Concentrate on the first letter of that big word. All right, and slowly in your mind, spell that word. The first letter I got was an H. Next letter is an E.
Yes.
An A.
Yes.
All right. I have heartbreakingly. Is that the word that you chose out of that magazine?
Yeah.
Heartbreakingly. All right, give Brenda a great big hand. Thank you, Brenda.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Good.
All right, let's see what else we have here. All right. I need two volunteers who have known each other a long time. Do we have any siblings over here?
Us three.
You three. All right. I'm going to do this, then I'll use you for siblings. And then I'll get you guys over here too, all right? So, before we get to the siblings and before we get these folks over here, I need two volunteers. I'm going to pick somebody over here because you're at a table. It just makes it easier, okay? Do you two know each other for a long time? Several weeks. Okay, good enough for me. And what's your name, please?
Susan.
Susan. And you are?
Jeff.
Susan and Jeff. I gotta go get my notepad. Be right back. All right, Susan and Jeff, let's see. Jeff, turn around. Susan, I'm gonna go get a notepad. In the meantime, I want you to deal 8 cards face up. And Jeff, I don't want you to peek. Now, if you don't like the card that you deal off the top, it can be another card. Okay. You just deal 8 cards face up, 2 rows of 4, and let me get my notepad, and I'll be right back. Because we're gonna do a test to see how well Jeff and, I'm sorry, what was your name again, please? Susan, Jeff and Susan, how well they can think alike and think to each other without the spoken word. All right, you have 8 cards on the table? All right, concentrate on those 8 cards. All right, so she's concentrating on 8 cards and she's gonna pick one. Susan, pick one card. No, 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 put it down. Pick a different card. Don't touch them.
Oh.
In your mind.
Oh, just in my mind? I'm new to this business.
Yeah, me too. In your mind, pick one of those cards. Let me take these, you're dangerous. All right.
Write
it down for us so we don't forget. All right. Turn that over so nobody can see it. All right. Let's turn the cards face over. Now take the marker. Okay, Susan, your turn to turn around. Because I don't want you to see what Jeff is going to do because you might give off body language. Okay, Jeff, you may turn around. We have 8 cards here, 2 rows of 4. What I'd like for you to do is slide 4 cards towards you, any 4 that you want.
Slide any 4 towards me.
Yep, huh? Slide 4 cards towards you. 1, 2, 3, 4. And pick them up and put them right there. All right, you keep concentrating on that card and send your thoughts to Jeff. Jeff, slide 2 cards towards you. All right. Push 1 card away. 1 card in the middle of the table. All right, let's see how well we did. Tell everybody what you wrote down, please.
9 of spades.
9 of spades, let's see the 9 of spades. Jeff, would you turn over that last card, please?
Oh.
The 9 of spades. Give Jeff and Susan a great big hand. Thank you, folks. Yeah, he did better than you did, yeah. All right, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, let me get the siblings first. Oh, actually, I should not have done that trick. Because we're gonna do it again, only with siblings. All right, who's the oldest?
Lisa.
All right. You had to think about that. All right, why don't you two come on up here, okay? Come on up here. So we're gonna, come on. You are Susan?
Huh?
What's your name, please?
Alicia.
Alicia.
Edmund?
Yeah. Fitzgerald?
What?
Never mind. Okay. Alicia, face that way. Edmund, face that way. So we're gonna do the same thing all over again. I should not have done that, but that's all right, because I have all kinds of different images here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over here. Let's see. Would you take one? All right. And would you take one? All right, 1, 2, 3. Would you take one? And would you take one? And there we go. All right, and you do. All right, may I have your picture, please? If you're holding a picture, look at your picture. This is the last time you get to look at your picture. Now hold it up like this so everybody can see it. Turn the picture around, hold it behind you, hold it to the side, hold it to the other side. And now, turn the pictures like this so Alicia can see all the pictures, okay? All right, because Edmund's not looking, right, Edmund? No, sorry. All right. All right. Okay, Alicia, did I pronounce it right? Alisa, okay. Look at those 8 pictures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. And again, in your mind, think of one of those pitches. Write it down and concentrate on it while you're writing it down. Edmund, did you see the pitches?
No.
Okay, good. There are 8 pitches out there, and Lisa is thinking of one, and while you're thinking of it, send your thoughts to your brother. You just concentrate on what she's trying to send to you, and you just concentrate really hard on what you're looking at. And I'll take the marker, hold that back so nobody can see it. Now, turn your pitches around so we can't see them. Can you turn that around, please? All right, Edmund. So by now you should know what to do, right? You're gonna go get me 4 pitches. There are 6 over there, and 1 here and 1 there. Go get me 4. And Elisa, you turn around so you can't see what your brother's doing. Stand right over here, please. Edmund, go get me 4 of the 8 pitches. That's 1. Try not to look at them. That's 2. That's 3. And that's 4. All right, go back and stand next to your sister. I'll take these, please, just to expedite things. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Thank you. Oop, I'm trying to prevent that. All right. All right, Edmund. Are you concentrating really hard? Edmund, take 2.
1 and 2.
All right, we'll get rid of those. Oop. Oops, sorry. Take 1.
This one.
Take it. And we'll get rid of that one. That leaves 1 pitcher left.
Yep.
Turn around. Hold the pitcher like that. Don't look at it. Okay, tell everybody what you wrote down.
Wizard.
Show everybody. Nice and loud. Wizard. And let's see, the last pitcher standing is
Wizard.
The Wizard. All right, give my volunteers a great big hand. Thank you, guys. All right, let's see here. All 6, come on up here. If you want. If you don't want, don't come up here. All right, you two don't want to help out? Do you want to help out? Sure, okay. Don't get too excited on me. What did you do to your arm?
I fell playing soccer.
Right at the beginning, well, it's middle summer now, huh?
Yeah.
All right. Why don't you come on over here? All the way over here. And would you come over here, please? And then would you come here? And would you two turn around right where you're standing? All right, and take a step backwards. So we have a straight line and I don't have to stand in front of the microphone and get squelched. Okay, we are going to do the quarter trick. Who brought the quarter? You came up here to do a quarter trick and you didn't think to bring a quarter? It's a good thing I brought a quarter. All right. Now, let me tell you something about money magic or coin magic. It's easy to learn, some of them can be hard to learn, but the easy thing is if you know a few coin magic tricks, it's easy to carry coins in your pocket. All right. But never say to your volunteer, what's your name, please?
Chloe.
Chloe. Never say, Chloe, take my quarter, because you just might. You say, Chloe, would you hold the quarter, please? All right, Chloe, I have pink, yellow, orange, and green stickers. Which color would you like? Pink. Yeah, no big surprise there. Stick that on the coin for us. Heads or tails, your choice. All right, pass it down to this person. And what's your name, please?
Olivia.
Olivia, what color would you like?
Yellow.
Yellow. You can pick pink if you want.
I guess.
Well, don't let me force you to pick a color. Anyone you want.
Green.
All right, we went from yellow to pink to green. All right. Stick that on the other side. Pass it to this young fella, and what's your name, please?
Charlie.
Charlie? Mm-hmm. Face the audience, Charlie. All right, Charlie, I have a whole bunch of markers here. I got red, orange, 2 purples, and 2 different greens. Pick a color, please. Now, do you want to write a letter or a number? Your choice.
Number.
Number. What's your favorite number? Somewhere between 0 and gazillion?
7.
7, okay. On one of those stickers, your choice, write a 7. An orange 7 on the green sticker. Pass the coin down to the next person. And what's your name, please?
Chase.
Shane?
Chase.
All right, let's get this in the center there. Chase. Pick a color. Red. And on the other sticker, do you want to write a number or a letter?
Letter.
A letter?
Yeah.
What letter do you want to write?
C.
C? Okay. There we go. I'll take the marker, pass it on this person. And what's your name, please?
Savannah.
Savannah. Savannah with the broken arm. Savannah, hold that really high so everybody can see it. Show them both sides, the pink and the green and the seven and the C. Alrighty. Make me reach. We're going to take the coin and put it right here into the middle of the handkerchief. Hang on nice and tight. Chase, grab the other end nice and tight. Would you like to help out? Because you haven't helped out yet. All right, you stand over there, okay? Keep going, way over there, way over there, way over there, further, further. All right. There we go. You get to hold the magic treasure chest, but don't open it yet. All right, on the count of three, I'll take this, please. Everybody gets to help. We're going to shout abracadabra on three. Are we ready? One, two, three. And the coin's going to fly all the way over there and land in the box. All right, that was good. That was like a little more than pathetic, but I think we can do better. Let's try that again. One, two, three.
Abracadabra!
What's your name, please?
Sebastian.
Sebastian. Cabot? No, okay, Sebastian. Open up the treasure chest, reach inside, and take out the quarter. And take it out and hold it really high. Hold that. Okay. All right, take the rubber bands off that and put them in here. All right, see where it says push here? Look at the other end of the box. Yeah, push there. There you go. And reach inside and take out the quarter. I'll take the gold box. Hold that really high. Show me what you found. All right, Dobby's sock. Now, Christmas must be fun at your house. And reach inside and take out the quarter. Hold that really high. Show everybody what you found. All right, I'll take the red sock. Open up the green sock. And let's see what we can find. And reach inside, see what we can find. Something in there? Good. You could just shake it out into your hand. All right, hold it really high, show you what you found. Bring the coin down there, let everybody look at it, make sure it's their colors, their numbers, their letters. All right, now, my coin, my sock. All right, give all my volunteers a great big hand. Thank you, guys. All right, let's see here. Ah, there it is. What is hypnotism? Who knows what hypnotism is? What's hypnotism? What's that?
It hypnotizes you.
Okay. Most people don't use the word in the word that they're trying to define. Hypnotism. Anybody else? Can you explain that a little further, maybe? No? Anybody over here? Hypnotism? Any big people? Hypnotism? You put somebody in a trance, and then what happens? Actually, I have found out, because I've been trying to learn hypnotism, that's the common misconception. People think if you go into hypnotic trance, which is why some people are afraid to volunteer, because you're going to be forced to do something you wouldn't normally do. But the truth is, a person in a hypnotic trance will already do what they would normally do anyways, which is really interesting, because most people think that they're being co-opted into doing something that they wouldn't do. But I've been wanting to learn hypnotism to add to my list of things that I do. And like everything else, you have to practice. And the problem I have run into is my family and friends won't let me practice on them. I practice on rope. I'm going to hypnotize the rope, and the rope is going to stand up on the count of three. One, two, Three, and the rope stands up. That's funny. I thought it was good. No? Were you expecting me to hold it with the left hand? All right, I'll hypnotize the rope, and I'll hold it with the left hand. One, two, three, and the rope stands up with the left hand. Well, tough audience. I held it in the right hand, and nobody was impressed. I held it in the left hand, and nobody was impressed. How do we take a person or an object out of a hypnotic trance? Do you know what we do? We snap our fingers. Now, if you can't snap, you can clap your hands. On three. One, two, three. Give yourselves a great big hand. All right. Let's see here. I need a volunteer who would like the chance to win $20. Come on up here, Mom. Or Grandma. Oh. All right. So you're willing to take $20 from a kid?
A kid? Yes, I am.
Okay, good. Come on over here. And what's your name, please?
Jane.
Jane. All right. Jane, here's how the game works. I have three roses here, pink, yellow, and red. I already know which one you are going to choose.
Okay.
I've written down my prediction, and I am so confident that I am willing to wager $20. So, in a moment, not just yet, you will choose one of these colors. If I am wrong, you win the $20.
Okay.
If I am right, you owe me $20.
I don't like this.
Who has $20? No. I'll tell you, we're going to change the rules today because we're being funded by the East Long Meadow Cultural Council. Right? We're in Long Meadow, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Does anybody here know Cynthia McNaught? She was the children's library years ago over at... Anyways, I'm going to change the rules.
Okay.
If my prediction is wrong, you will indeed win the $20.
Okay.
If my prediction is right, I keep the $20.
I like that.
So you can win, but not lose. I can lose or break even.
Okay.
Fair? All right. Give them a little stir. All right. Just remember, one of them could have won this, you know. All right. Nice and loud, shout out one of those colors.
Yellow.
Yellow? Would you remove the yellow rose from the vase, please? Is there a message on the bottom of the yellow rose?
Will you select the yellow rose?
Not will you, you will.
Oh, you will select the yellow rose.
You did. My prediction is right. My $20 is safe. Give her a great big hand. Thank you. Well, you're easy. I don't know. Are we? Anybody think we're all done? Or okay, we got, well, hold on. What do you think's going on here? They all say you'll select the yellow rose? Oh, yeah, the light bulb comes on. Come on back here. And what's your name again, please?
Jane.
Jane, that's right, Jane. See, I didn't make it, I should have said Jane Seymour, but I didn't make.
Exactly, connection.
You know, right. I do, that's why I say with the names. It helps me with word association.
Okay.
All right. And we just saw Horrible Histories. And one of these episodes was about Henry VIII. All right. So you think they all say you will select whichever color is on the bottom?
Yes.
No.
Oh, you say no.
Because I can see, no.
Oh. Well, how'd you do that?
I peeked.
Another one?
Oh.
Okay.
Take out the other one. Anything in the bottom of the vase?
No.
Just the one.
How did you? Oh.
Give Jane a great big hand. Thank you, Jane.
You.
Jane, ever since I've been doing this, this is the original $20 bill, and I have not lost it yet. All righty, let's see here. Oh, so much time is so little to do. I think we have time for a couple more, yes? All right. Well, let me teach one. Let me teach one. Alicia, I wrote something on the back of this plate. Do you know exactly what I wrote on the back of this plate? You're absolutely right. There. So get yourself a paper plate, write no with an exclamation point. Hold this so it's upside down to you, because if you can read it and you turn it over, it says ion, and that only works in science conventions. So it says no. So the question to your volunteer is, do you know exactly what I wrote in the back of this plate? What's the only answer they can give? No. Now, if they say happy birthday, you respond by saying, do you know that or is it a guess? I don't want you to guess. I'm asking you if you truly know what's on the back of this plate. Ed the Wizard, is that another guess? Yes, I don't want to guess. So sometimes you have to lead your volunteer away from guesses. But can you repeat this magic effect? Can I do this a second time?
Yeah.
No. Do you know why? Who said yes? Edmund, right? See, Edmund Fitzgerald. Edmund, do you know why I can't do this a second time?
No.
All right, Edmund, now do you know what I wrote in the back of this plate?
Yes.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. So I get a second plate ready in case we get a little wise guy who says, ooh, pick me, because they're going to say, okay, do you know what's on the back of this plate? Thinking it says no, they're going to say yes, and then I got Edmund. Edmund didn't give me. Give Edmund a great big hand. Give Alicia a great big hand. All right, let's see here. I think we'll do two more. We'll do this one. So I need another volunteer. Somebody, you don't have to know your cards, but you have to know how to spell your name. Come on up here. And what's your name, please?
Natalie,
stand right here. All right. Now, I could say Natalie Wood. That would help me, but I think I can remember this. Natalie, I'm going to flip the cards. You're going to say stop. Where we stop, that will be your randomly selected card. Are you ready, Natalie?
Sure. Oh, do I say it? Oh, two hearts.
No, you're supposed to say stop.
Oh, my God.
You want me to pick him? No. Okay. All right, Natalie. All right. Sometimes I get a little fast. I'll slow it down. Okay. Natalie. I'm going to flip the card. I was explaining what we're going to do. Because clearly I didn't explain it well enough the first time. And at some point you will say stop. Are we ready?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you positive?
No.
Here we go.
Stop. Ooh. No.
One more time. Here we go.
Stop.
I haven't started yet.
Stop.
Right there? You want to keep going? Or you want?
No, that's good.
That's good?
Yeah.
You want that card or this card?
That card.
All right. Don't show it to me.
I won't.
Natalie, take the marker on the face. That's this side, not the blue side. The face side, write your name. Now, what I like about this is I can use little ones because all they have to do is make some sort of mark and then we know it's their card. They don't have to remember what the card is, but try to remember if you can. When you're done, Natalie, put the cap on the pen, put the pen in the hand. All right. Natalie, show everybody your card, please. Hold it up like this. And now hold the card face down like that. Again, tell me when to stop. Right there. Put the card right there. All right. Here we go. Natalie's card. Watch this. This is really cool. You ready? Pretty neat, huh? So there's three parts to a card effect. Find a card, which Natalie did. Lose a card, which I'm trying to do now. And the third part is what, Natalie?
Find the card.
Find the card. Yeah. All right. However, your name is on it. That would make it way too easy. Mm-hmm. I'm going to use my friend. Duck. What are you doing? Somebody shouts duck. Duck!
Yeah.
Duck! Yeah. Duck! It's a verb, right?
Yeah.
So duck! Duck! No, look over here. It's a noun, see? Yeah. You know what kind of duck this is? It's a wood duck.
Yeah.
Okay. You're made out of wood. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Are you ready, duck? Okay. Duck is ready. Duck, go find Natalie's card. What's the matter, duck? Really? Duck says he knows how to read. I know, I'm getting there. And he wants to do it the hard way. I am getting there with a blindfold. Mm-hmm. just like my grandmother. He bites.
Ow!
All right, Duck, are you ready? What do you mean, no? He's afraid of the dark. All right, Duck, here we go. Reach in and grab a card. Try again, you missed. You missed again. Oh, you got a whole bunch this time. Let's see. It's not the Nine of Diamonds because it doesn't have your name, but I think it's a red card. Am I right?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see. Can't be the Two of Clubs because that's not a red card. It could be the Four of Hearts. It could be the Ace of Hearts, but I think it's the Three of Hearts. There you go. That's your card. Has your name on it. Give Natalie a great big hand. All right. We have one more. Time for one more. One of my favorites. And we'll just put a couple of things to the side here. Who knows what this is? No. This is the ancient, mysterious, mystical, magical, expensive, slightly dented Chinese chest. Ah, the music's over, see? The show must be over. We'll just start it again. This is a box. It's a wicked cheap box, I know, because I made it, but that's not the point. The point is it's home to the Golden Cube. I'm going to take the Golden Cube. I'm going to put it inside the ancient, mysterious, mystical, magical, expensive, slightly dented Chinese chest like that. You're going to help me say the magic words, and the Golden Cube is going to magically fly back to the cheap purple box like that. Everybody take the hand and wave and say abracadabra. Alakazam. Poof, and point to the cheap purple box. And you can see that the Golden Cube is no longer inside the ancient, mysterious, mystical, magical, expensive, slightly dented Chinese chest. It is, what's that? Edmund, did you have something to say? Back over here. What's the matter, Edmund? You can tell me. I'm a big boy. What do you think happened?
It's part of the trick.
Yeah.
It said you never put it in there.
Ah.
Never put it in.
You know, Edmund, everything I've learned, I've learned from reading magic books. And the magic book said you wouldn't notice. So it's not my fault. All right, one more time. Golden Cube into the ancient, mysterious, mystical, magical, expensive, slightly dented Chinese chest. Is that better, Edmund? Are you sure?
Yes.
All right, Edmund. Here we go. Golden Cube into the ancient, mysterious, mystical, magical, expensive, slightly dented Chinese chest. Now, is that better?
Yes.
Okay. Now, wave your hands, say abracadabra. Alakazam. Poof. Gone. Yes? No? Edmund? Turn around. Gone. Yes. Or are you expecting me to turn the box around? Gone. The other side. Gone.
It's on the outside.
Here?
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Both? Both at once.
Both at once. Yes? No? Maybe? How about you guys over there?
Both at once.
Both of these at once? What?
The two fronts.
The two fronts. You mean this one and that one?
At the same time.
I can't do the same time. Two doors, one hand. Physically impossible. But I can do this. I can open each door one at a time and leave them open. Would you like that?
Yes.
All right, here we go. One, and I will leave it open. And two, and I will leave it open. And three, oh, look at the time. I have to go. I'll tell you what, we'll come back next year. We'll start with this one, and you guys enjoy the summer and have a good school year, and I'll see you next July, okay? Alicia, do we have time to finish this?
You have time to finish this?
No, you're supposed to say no. No. No, you're supposed to say come back next year. 3 and 4. Because the golden cube is back over here in the cheap purple box where it belongs. Give yourselves a great big hand. So, before we go, I like to do question and answers. The first answer is, the fire is not real, but don't come up to touch to prove it because the light bulbs are hot. The dragon, the fairy, they're my familiars. They go home with me. They help me with my magic. Yes, this is real. Mrs. Wizard says I have way too much hair. I keep telling Mrs. Wizard, I wish I had a little bit more. And, because they fit. Think about it. So let me ask you a question before you ask me something. Who is funding today's program? Who remembers? The East Longmeadow Cultural Council, and they would love to hear from you. Any cultural council program you attend during the year, send them a thank you note because they love to hear the input from the community. Who has a question for me? Who I am, what I do, why I do it, why my family puts up with me? Everybody knows everything, huh? All right, well, I'm gonna pack up. If you have a question, come on up and ask a question. And otherwise, thanks for having me, and we'll see you down the road. Thank you.